Well, good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to another Sunday Kids Space. It's so good to have you along here today as we take a look at another incredible story from the Bible. And today, we're taking a look at the story of Esther. And this is an incredible story about a young woman who stands up for her people and saves them in an incredible way. There was a time when the Jews lived in a country called Persia, which was ruled by a king whose name was Xerxes. It's a very strange name, isn't it? You don't see many people in Northern Ireland called that. The king had a beautiful queen named Vashti, who he wished to show off to all the men in his court. Vashti refused to be shown off by the king, and full of fury at being disobeyed, he decided to find a new queen to replace her. Esther was a young and very beautiful Jewish orphan who had been brought up as a daughter by her cousin Mordecai. The king decided that Esther, out of all the women in his kingdom, should be his new queen. Mordecai instructed her to not reveal or to tell anyone that she was a Jew. But sitting at the king's gate one day, Mordecai overheard two palace officers plotting to kill King Xerxes. He sent a warning to the king Xerxes and saved his life. And because of this, Mordecai's name was written in the royal record book. This was a very important book to get written in. Mordecai had an enemy, however, close to the king named Haman. Haman disliked Mordecai because he refused to bow to him whenever Haman passed by. Mordecai would only bow before God. Haman was so angry with Mordecai that he tricked the king into passing a law that on a certain date, Mordecai and all the other Jews in Persia would be put to death. It was very dangerous for Esther to approach the king without his permission, but Mordecai persuaded her she had been put close to the king by God, especially to save the Jews. Esther came up with a plan and invited the king and Haman to a banquet the next day. Haman was impatient to have Mordecai killed before all the other Jews, so he set up a gallows and planned to ask the king the next day to have Mordecai hanged there. That night, the king could not sleep and asked to hear the royal record book. Remember that important book? He wanted it read aloud. Realizing Mordecai had never been rewarded for saving his life, the king the next day asked Haman, "What should be done for a man the king delights to honour?" Haman, thinking the king was talking about him, painted a rich picture of all the honours that should be given to him. Pleased with Haman's suggestions, the king ordered him to go and arrange all these honours for Mordecai. Mordecai was given the king's horse and robe, and Haman was forced to lead him through the streets for all to see. Haman was humiliated. Later that day, Haman and the king went to Esther's banquet. The king was so pleased with her that he agreed to grant any request she made. Esther then told the king about Haman's plot to kill her people and asked him to save them. "Hang Haman," the king called in fury. And so, Haman was defeated and the king passed a new law that saved the Jews from their fate. Mordecai took Haman's place as the king's favourite. God did this through the beautiful Queen Esther. And this story, boys and girls, is an amazing story about being used by God. And today, sometimes we may feel that we're not that important. If you remember back in the story, Esther was an orphan. She didn't have a mum and her dad. It was actually her cousin raised her. But yet, she was used by God to save her people. Now for us, we may never and probably will never be used as such a big thing as Esther was. Esther was used to save all of her people. She was used to save the Jews. But God can use us where we are today. But there's something very important that we must do. And that is, we must be open and we must allow God to use us. Because that's what Esther did. That's what Mordecai did. And because of this, they were able to do incredible things. So boys and girls, when we hear about Esther, when we hear about Queen Esther, we can remember that she was a woman who loved God, who followed him and allowed God to use her for his glory and his purposes. So thank you so much for boys and girls for tuning in, and it's been so great to tell you this story. I love the story of Esther. So I hope that you will remember this and go and tell maybe your mum and your dad about this, or your granny and granddad, about what you've learned about Esther and how amazing she was.
Praise goes.